साक्षीभूतं भावातीतं त्रिगुणहितं सद्गुरुं तं नमामि। Nityanandam, and welcome to the morning Uttamottama Buksha Upachara Yukta Puja offered at the Divine Lotus Feet of Sri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sameta Sri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva. Paramashiva is the source and the foundation of the very cosmos. He performs the five cosmic actions of creation, sustenance, rejuvenation, putting into delusion, and liberation. It is for the devotion of the devotee that Paramashiva manifests the entire cosmos. He moves by the devotion of the devotees. For us, he manifests everything in our lives. As Bhagavan Sri Nityananda Paramashiva says, we hold everyone in our lives to be Paramashiva, to be in oneness with Paramashiva. The same way, to be able to relate with Paramashiva, to be able to connect with him, most easiest way, the source scriptures that Paramashiva himself gave, describe various kinds of pujas that can be offered. These are from various types of pujas offered to various manifestations and incarnations of Paramashiva in various different forms. The supreme most form that Paramashiva manifests as is in the form of the Shivalinga, the Paramashiva Linga, which is said to be the formless in form itself, to be able to connect with both the aspects of Paramashiva, that is the unmanifest and the manifest. In the cosmos, Paramashiva exists as Vyakta and Avyakta, as all the manifestation and all the manifestation that is yet to be, and the pure consciousness that is pure energy. So the form that encapsulates the entire cosmos of Paramashiva is the Paramashiva Linga. Here in Adi Kailasa Nityananda Peeta, Sri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva Devalaya, we have one of the most powerful Shivalingas that is known. This Shivalinga is known as Swayambhu. Swayambhu Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva. Swayambhu means it is self-manifest. Cosmos manifests cosmos and Prakriti, the cosmic energy and the cosmic consciousness, came together and created and made a Shivalinga for all of us to connect with, for all of us to worship. And that is Sri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva, Swayambhu Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva, who is the very body of Paramashiva himself. Having his darshan, seeing him as often as possible, is what Bhagavan Sri Nityananda Paramashiva, the Supreme Pontiff of Hinduism, is giving the world an opportunity to pour through this Uttamottama Seva. Seeing the deity have his abhishekam, it brings tremendous tranquility and peace into one's soul. It brings tremendous serenity and peace. First thing in the morning, when one wakes up and connects with Paramashiva and sees his puja and offers their prayers and worship, their day will be the best day. Not only is it the best of the best sevas to offer to Parmashiva, Uttamottama Seva is said in Agama to be the best of the best sevas, but it is the best of the best ways to receive Parmashiva every day morning and have his darshan. Offer your prayers to him and celebrate your oneness with him. Today, we'll begin the Uttamottama Paksha, Upacharikta Puja, shortly. Before that, we have some exciting events that are happening in the Sri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva Devalayam. Here, in Sri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva Devalayam, yesterday, the Brahmotsava, the Kartika Deepa Brahmotsava of Sri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva had begun here in the temple. Kartika Deepa Brahmotsava is one of the most celebrated Brahmotsavas, and it's very dear to our Bhagavan's life because he grew up in the Arunachaleshwara temple, where it is a temple city. All the people, everybody is thinking about this particular Brahmotsavam every year, talking about it, planning for it. Almost all year they plan to be able to have a grand Brahmotsavam for their Lord Arunachaleshwara in Tiruvannamalai. In the same way, Bhagavan had grown up with this excitement and this temple-based living around him. And in the same way, he has created in so many temples around the world. All the Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva Devalayas around the world are also celebrating the Sri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva Brahmotsavam and doing with grand rituals and celebration. First day, yesterday, the Dhujarohanam, the flag was hoisted for the Brahmotsavam. Following the flag hoisting, we had the rituals and various celebrations with the deities of Parmashiva. The Purapad, the Abhishekam, and as well as the processional and the darshan of the Utsava Vigrahas of the temple. Parmashiva celebrates his Brahmotsava through the Utsava Vigrahas, those deities that are Archavataras, that are cosmic energy manifest to accept our prayers. These particular deities of Utsava Vigrahas come around at the times of celebration out of the temple compound and into the villages, so people themselves can come and see their Lord come to their home and they receive him. They see the Utsavam, the grand celebration of their deities, of the Paramashiva himself coming with all of his family all around the city. In the next coming days of the Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva Brahmotsavam of Kartika Deepa, the final day is known as the Kartika Deepam Day. It is on the 29th of this month. On that day, many Paramashiva will manifest in the form of a Jyoti, a Paramashiva Jyoti, that is the Bharani Deepam, or festival in the morning, during the Nakshatra of Bharani, the lamp is manifest as Paramashiva. A ghee lamp is manifest as Paramashiva. And from that, many lamps are lit, signifying the origins of the cosmos. When alone Paramashiva existed and decided that let him become many to celebrate himself, so he has become many. The evening culminates with the celebration of oneness, celebration of his Leela, and a celebration of his way of giving anugraha, liberation, oneness with Paramashiva. All the lamps lit and maintained throughout the day of Kartika Deepam return back to one single lamp that is lit in the evening, signifying oneness with Paramashiva. All of us merge back into him All of us are Angadevatas, are part of him. That is on the final day of this Brahmotsavam. Tomorrow evening, there will be a unique Shankabhishekam offered at the divine, at for Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva, the Swayam Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva. Today, after the Uttamottama Vaksha Upacharik, the puja today, we'll have a separate celebration of Basma Abhishekam offered to Moolapura Nityanandeshwara. Basma Abhishekam is an offering of Basma, the ash, the sacred ash that is the favorite of Paramashiva. That will be offered at 9 a.m. today after the Uttamoksama Paksha Upachara Yukta Puja. So today, let us get ready to receive darshan of Paramashiva. Please be seated with your head, neck and spine in a straight line. Inhale and exhale as deeply as possible and as slowly as possible. Internally chant the Mahavakya. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham.
Shivoham Om Nityananda Paramashivoham.
ओम नित्यानंदं परमसुखदं केवलं ज्ञानमूर्तिं नुन्द्वातीतं गगनसदृशं तत्त्वमस्यादिलक्ष्यं एकं नित्यं विमलमचलं सर्वधी साक्षीभूतं भावातीतं त्रिगुणरहितं सद्गुरुं तं नमामि नित्यानन्देश्वर परमशिवसमारम्भां नित्यानन्देश्वरि पराशक्तिमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम् ललाटे त्रिपुंद्री तिलकृत कस्तूरी तिलक स्फुरन्मालाधार स्फुरितकटि गोपी नवसनः ददानो दुष्टारं चिरसि फणिराजं शशिकलां प्रदीप सर्वेषां अरुणगिरि योगी विजयते। ओम गणानां त्वा गणपति गुं हवामहे कविं कवीनामुपमश्रवस्तमं ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पतान शृण्वन्नूतिभिस्सीद सादनम् ओम श्री महागणपतये नमः। ओम व्योमव्यापिने व्योमरूपाय सर्वव्यापिने शिवाय अनन्ताय अनाथाय अनाश्रिताय ध्रुवाय शाश्वताय योगपीठसंस्थिताय नित्ययोगिने ध्यानाहाराय ओम नमः शिवाय सर्वप्रभवे शिवाय ईशानमूर्धाय तत्पुरुषवक्त्राय अघोरकृतयाय वामदेवगुह्याय सद्योजातमूर्तये ओम नमो नमः गुह्यादिगुह्याय गोप्त्रे अनिधनाय सर्वविद्याधिपाय ज्योतिरूपाय परमेश्वरपराय अचेतन अचेतन व्योमिन् व्योमिन् व्यापिन् व्यापिन् अरूपिन् अरूपिन् प्रथमः प्रथमा तेजस्तेजः ज्योतिर्ज्योतिः अरूपा अनग्नि अधूमा अभस्म अनादे नाना धू 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 ओम भूः ओम भुवः ओम स्वः अनिधन निधन निधनोद्भव शिव सर्व परमात्मन् महेश्वर महादेव सद्भावेश्वर महातेजः योगाधिपते मुञ्ज मुञ्ज प्रथम प्रथम शर्व शर्व भव भव भवोद्भव सर्वभूतसुखप्रद सर्वसान्निध्यकर ब्रह्मविष्णुरुद्रपर अनर्चितानर्चिता असंस्तुता संस्तुता पूर्वस्थिता पूर्वस्थिता साक्षिन् साक्षिन् तरु तरु पतंग पतंग पिंग पिंग ज्ञान ज्ञान शब्द शब्द सूक्ष्म सूक्ष्म शिव सर्वधा ओम नमः शिवाय ओम नमो नमः शिवाय नमो नमः ओम।
ओम दशांगंगुगुलोपेतं सुगंधं सुमनोहरं आग्रयः सर्वदेवानां धूपोयं प्रतिगृह्यताम्। ओम हां हूं शिवाय नमः। श्री नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्ति समेत श्री नित्यानंदेश्वर परम शिवाय नमः। धूपमाग्रापयामि। ओम उद्दीप्यस्वजातवेदापग्निं निरृतं मम पशुकुश्यमह्यमावह जीवनं चतिशोदश मानोहिकं सीर्जातवेदोगामस्वं पुरुषं जगद् अभिभृतज्ञागहि श्रियाम परिपातया। ओम हां शिवाय नमः। श्री नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्ति समेत श्री नित्यानंदेश्वर परम शिवाय नमः। दीपं दर्शयामि। ओम बम अमृते अमृतोद्भवे अमृतवर्षिणी अमृतम श्रावय श्रावे स्वाहा। ओम हां हूं शिवाय नमः। श्री नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्ति समेत श्री नित्यानंदेश्वर परम शिवाय नमः। अमृतम महानैवेद्यम निवेदयामि नीराजनम। ओम अद्योजातं प्रपद्यामि सद्योजाताय वै नमो नमः। भवे भवे नाति भवे भवस्म मां भवोद्भवाय नमः। ओम हां हूं शिवाय नमः। श्री नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्ति समेत श्री नित्यानंदेश्वर परम शिवाय नमः। नीराजनम संदर्शयामि रक्षां धारयामि। ओम शिवाय नमः। ओम महेश्वराय नमः। ओम चंबवे नमः। ओम पिनाकिने नमः। ओम शशिशेखराय नमः। ओम नामदेवाय नमः। ओम रूपाक्षाय नमः। ओम कपर्दिने नमः। ओम नीललोहिताय नमः। ओम शंकराय नमः। ओम शूलपानये नमः। ओम खड्वांगिने नमः। ओम विष्णुवल्लभाय नमः। ओम शिपिविष्ठाय नमः। ओम अंबिकानाथाय नमः। ओम श्रीकंठाय नमः। ओम भक्तवत्सलाय नमः। ओम भवाय नमः। ओम शर्वाय नमः। ओम त्रिलोकेशाय नमः। ओम शितिकंठाय नमः। ओम शिवप्रियाय नमः। ओम उग्राय नमः। ओम कपालिने नमः। ओम कौमारय नमः। ओम मंडकासुरसूदनाय नमः। ओम गंगाधराय नमः। ओम ललाटाक्षाय नमः। ओम कालकालाय नमः। ओम कृपानिधये नमः। ओम भीमाय नमः। ओम परशुहस्ताय नमः। ओम मृगपाणये नमः। ओम जटाधराय नमः। ओम कदितल्लसासिने नमः। ओम कवचिने नमः। ओम कठोराय नमः। ओम त्रिपुरांतकाय नमः। ओम वृषांकाय नमः। ओम वृषभारूढाय नमः। ओम भस्मोद्धूलित विग्रहाय नमः। ओम सामप्रियाय नमः। ओम स्वरमयाय नमः। ओम त्रयीमूर्तये नमः। ओम मनीश्वराय नमः। ओम सर्वज्ञाय नमः। ओम परमात्मने नमः। ओम सोमसूर्याग्निलोचनाय नमः। ओम हविषे नमः। ओम यज्ञमयाय नमः। ओम सोमाय नमः। ओम पंचवक्त्राय नमः। ओम सदाशिवाय नमः। ओम विश्वेश्वराय नमः। ओम वीरभद्राय नमः ॐ गणनाथाय नमः ॐ प्रजापतये नमः ॐ हिरण्यनेतसे नमः ॐ दुर्धर्षाय नमः ॐ गिरीशाय नमः ॐ गिरिशाय नमः ॐ मनघाय नमः ॐ भुजंगभूषणाय नमः ॐ वर्गाय नमः ॐ गिरिधन्वने नमः ॐ गिरिप्रियाय नमः ॐ कृत्तिवाससे नमः ॐ पुराराधये नमः ॐ भगवते नमः ॐ ब्रह्मधाधिपाय नमः ॐ मृत्युञ्जयाय नमः ॐ सूक्ष्मतनवे नमः ॐ ॐ सूक्ष्मतनवे नमः ॐ जगद्व्यापिने नमः ॐ जगद्गुरवे नमः ॐ व्योमकेशाय नमः ॐ महासेनजनकाय नमः ॐ चारुविक्रमाय नमः ॐ रुद्राय नमः ॐ भूतपतये नमः ॐ स्थानवे नमः ॐ महिर्भूत्नाय नमः ॐ दिगंबराय नमः ॐ अष्टमूर्तये नमः ॐ अनेकात्मने नमः ॐ सात्विकाय नमः ॐ शुद्धविग्रहाय नमः ॐ शाश्वताय नमः ॐ खंडवरसवे नमः ॐ मजाय नमः ॐ पाशविमोचकाय नमः ॐ मृडाय नमः ॐ पशुपतये नमः ॐ देवाय नमः ॐ महादेवाय नमः ॐ नव्ययाय नमः ॐ हरये नमः ॐ पुष्पदंटविधे नमः ॐ अव्यग्राय नमः ॐ दक्षाध्वरहराय नमः ॐ हराय नमः ॐ भगनेत्रविधे नमः ॐ नव्यक्ताय नमः ॐ सहस्राक्षाय नमः ॐ सहस्रपादे नमः ॐ अपवर्गप्रवर्धनाय नमः ॐ अनन्ताय नमः ॐ तारकाय नमः ॐ परमेश्वराय नमः ॐ श्री नित्यानन्देश्वर परमशिवाय नमः
शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवो
ॐ नमो भगवते रुद्राय ॐ नमस्ते रुद्रमन्यवौतो तैषवे नमः नमस्ते अस्तु धन्वने बाहुभ्यामुतते नमः यात इषु शिवतमा शिवं बभूवते दनुः शिवाशरव्या यातवतया नो रुद्रमृणया याते रुद्रशिवा तनूरघोरा पापकाशिनी तया नस्तनुवाशन्तमया गिरिशं तापि चाकशीः यामिषुं गिरिशन्तहस्तेऽभिभर्षस्तवे शिवाङ्गिरित्रतां कुरु माहि गुंसि पुरुषं जगत् शिवेन वचसा त्वा गिरिशाच्छावधामसि यथा नः सर्वमिज्जगदयक्ष्मगुं सुमना असत् अध्यवोचदति वक्ताः प्रथमो देव्योऽभिषक् अहीगश्च सर्वा आञ्जम्भयन् सर्वा आश्च यातु धान्यः असो यस्ताम्रो अरुण उत बभ्रुः सुमङ्गलः ये चेमागुं रुद्रा अभितो दिक्षुः श्रुता सहस्रशो वैशाकुम्भेण ईमहे असो यो वसर्पति नीलग्रीवो विलोहितः उदैनं गोपादृशन्नदृशन्नुदहार्यः उतैनं विश्वा भूतानि सदृष्टो मृडयाप्तिनः अतो ये अस्य सत्त्वा नोहन्तेभ्यो कर्णमः प्रमुञ्चनस्त्वमुभयोनात्नियोज्याम् याश्च ते हस्तैषवः पराता भगवो वप अवतत्य धनुस्त्वगुं सहस्राक्षसते शुधे निशीर्य शल्यानां मुखा शिवो नः सुमना भव विद्यं दनुःकपर्तिनो विशल्यो भानवागुम्नुता अनेसन्नस्येष वाभुरस्य निषङ्गतिः याते हेतिर्मीडुष्ठमहस्ते बभूवते दनुः तयास्मान् विश्वतस्त्वमयक्ष्मया परिभुज नमस्ते अस्त्वायुधायानातताय धृष्णवे उभाभ्यामुतते नमो बाहुभ्यां तव धन्वने परिते धन्वनो हेतिरस्मान् व्रणक्तु विश्वतः नथो यशुधिस्तवरे अस्मन्निदेहितम्। शंभवे नमः। नमस्ते अस्तु भगवन् विश्वेश्वराय महादेवाय त्रयंबकाय त्रिपुरांतकाय त्रिकालाग्निकालाय कालाग्निरुद्राय नीलकंठाय नित्यानंदाय मृत्युंजयाय सर्वेश्वराय सदाशिवाय श्रीमन्महादेवाय नमः। नमो हिरण्यबाहवे सेनान्ये दिशांच पतये। नमो नमो वृक्षेभ्यो हरिकेशेभ्यः पशूनां पतये। नमो नम सस्पिञ्जराय त्विषीमते पत्तीनां पतये। नमो नमो बब्लुषाय विव्याधिने नानां पतये। नमो नमो हरिकेशायोपतीतिने बुष्टानां पतये। नमो नमो भवस्य हेत्ये जगतां पतये। नमो नमो रुद्राय तताविने क्षेत्राणां पतये। नमो नमः सूताय हन्त्याय वनानां पतये। नमो नमो रोहिताय स्तपतये वृक्षाणां पतये। नमो नमो मन्त्रिणे वाणिजाय कक्षाणां पतये। नमो नमो भुवंतये वारिवस्कृतायौषधीनां पतये। नमो नम उच्चैर् घोषाया क्रंदयते वत्तीनां पतये। नमो नम कृत्स्नवीताय धावते सत्वनां पतये नमः। नमस्सहमानाय निव्याधिना व्याधिनीनां पतये। नमो नमः ककुभाय निषंगिने एस्तेनानां पतये। नमो नमो निचेरवे निषंगिन इषुधिमते तस्करानां पतये। नमो नमो वंचते परिवंचते स्तायूनां पतये। नमो नमो निचेरवे परिचरायारण्यानां पतये। नमो नमः श्रीकाविभ्यो जिगागुंसद्भ्यो मुष्णतां पतये। नमो नमः सिमद्भ्यो नक्तञ्चरभ्यः प्रकृन्तानां पतये। नमो नमः उष्णीषिणे गिरिचराय कुलुञ्जानां पतये। नमो नमः इषुमद्भ्यो दन्वाविभ्यश्च वो नमो नम आतन्वानेभ्य प्रतिदधानेभ्यश्च वो नमो नम आयच्छद्भ्यो वृषजद्भ्यश्च वो नमो नमोऽस्यद्भ्यो विद्यद्भ्यश्च वो नमो नम आसीनेभ्यस्यानेभ्यश्च वो नमो नमः क्षत्रिभ्यः संग्रहीतृभ्यश्च वो नमो नमस्तक्षभ्यो रतखारेभ्यश्च वो नमो नमः कुलालेभ्यः कर्मारेभ्यश्च वो नमो नमः पुञ्जिष्टेभ्यो निषादेभ्यश्च वो नमो नमः इषुकृद्भ्यो दन्वकृद्भ्यश्च वो नमो नमो मृगयुभ्यश्वनिभ्यश्च वो नमो नमः श्वभ्य श्वपतिभ्यश्च वो नमः। नम आव्याधिनीभ्यश्च वो नमो नम उगनाभ्यस्त्रिगुंहतेभ्यश्च वो नमो नम गृत्सेभ्यो गृत्सपतिभ्यश्च वो नमो नमो व्रातेभ्यो व्रातपतिभ्यश्च वो नमो नमो गणेभ्यो गणपतिभ्यश्च वो नमो नमो विरूपेभ्यो विश्वरूपेभ्यश्च वो नमो नमो महद्भ्यः क्षुल्लकेभ्यश्च वो नमो नमो रथिभ्यो रथेभ्यश्च वो नमो नमो रथे एभ्यो रथपतिभ्यश्च वो नमो नमः सेनाभ्यस्सेनानिभ्यश्च वो नमो नमः क्षत्रुभ्य संग्रहीतृभ्यश्च वो नमो नमः तक्षभ्यो रथकारेभ्यश्च वो नमो नमः कुलालेभ्यः कर्मारेभ्यश्च वो नमो नमः पुञ्जिष्टेभ्यो निषादेभ्यश्च वो नमो नम इषुकृद्भ्यो दन्वकृद्भ्यश्च वो नमो 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 मृगयुभ्यश्वनिभ्यश्च वो नमो नमो श्वभ्यश्वपदिभ्यश्च वो नमः। नमो भवाय च रुद्राय च नमः शर्वाय च पशुपतये च नमो नीलग्रीवाय च सितिकण्ठाय च नमः कपर्धिने च व्युक्तकेशाय च नमः सहस्राक्षाय च शतधन्वने च नमो गिरिशाय च चिपिविष्ठाय च नमो मीडुष्टमाय च सुमते च नमो ह्रस्वाय च वामनाय च नमो बृहते च वरिषीयसे च नमो वृद्धाय च संवृद्ध्वने च नमो अग्र्याय च प्रथमाय च नमः आशवे च चिराय च नमः शीघ्रियाय च शीभ्याय च नमः ऊर्म्याय च वस्वन्याय च नमः स्रोतस्याय च द्वीप्याय च नमो ज्येष्ठाय च कनिष्ठाय च नमः पूर्वजाय च परजाय च नमो मध्यमाय च बगल्पाय च नमो जगन्याय च भुज्ञाय च नमः सोभ्याय च प्रतिसर्याय च नमो याम्याय च क्षेम्याय च नमः उर्वर्याय च खल्याय च नमः श्लोक्याय च वसान्याय च नमो वन्याय च कक्षाय च नमः श्रमाय च प्रतिश्रवाय च नमः आशुषेनाय चासुरताय च नमः सूराय चावभिन्दते च नमो वर्मिने च वरूधिने च नमो भिल्मिने च कवचिने च नमः श्रुताय च श्रुतसेनाय च तत्र सूर्यो भाति न चन्द्रतारकं नेमा विद्युतो भान्ति कुठोऽयमग्निः तमेव भान्तमनुभाति सर्वं नस्य भाषा सर्वमिभं विभाति। ॐ हां हौं शिवाय नमः। श्री नित्यानन्देश्वरी पराशक्ति समेत श्री नित्यानन्देश्वर परम शिवाय नमः। नीराजनं सन्दर्शयामि। नमो दुन्दुभ्याय च हनन्याय च नमो धृष्णवे च प्रमृषाय च नमो दूताय च प्रहिताय च नमो निषङ्गिणे च शुधिमते च नमः तीक्ष्णे च वेचायुधिने च नमः स्वायुधाय च सुधन्वने च नमः श्रुत्याय च पत्याय च नमः काट्याय च नीप्याय च नमः सूत्याय च सरस्याय च नमो नाड्याय च वैशन्ताय च नमः कूप्याय च वट्याय च नमो वर्षाय च वर्षाय च नमो मेघ्याय च विद्युत्याय च नमः ईद्रियाय च तप्याय च नमो पात्याय च रेश्मियाय च नमो वास्तव्याय च वास्तुपाय च ॐ नमः सोमाय च रुद्राय च नमः स्ताम्राय चारुणाय च नमः शङ्घाय च पशुपतये च नमो नीलग्रीवाय च सिद्धिकण्ठाय च नमः कपर्दिने च व्युक्तकेशाय च नमः सहस्राक्षाय च शतधन्वने च नमो गिरिशाय च शिपिविष्टाय च नमो मीडुष्ठमाय चेशुमते च नमो ह्रस्वाय च वामनाय च नमो बृहते च वर्षीयसे च नमो वृद्धाय च संवृद्धने च नमो ॐ नमः सोमाय च रुद्राय च नमः स्ताम्राय चारुणाय च नमः शृङ्गाय च पशुपतये च नमः उग्राय च भीमाय च नमो अग्रे वधाय च धूरे वधाय च नमो हन्द्रे च हनीयसे च नमो वृक्षेभ्यो हरिकेशेभ्यो नमस्ताराय नमः शम्भवे च मयोभवे च नमः शङ्कराय च मयस्कराय च नमः शिवाय च शिवतराय च नमः स्तीर्थ्याय च कूल्याय च नमः पार्याय च वार्याय च नमः प्रतरणाय चोत्तरणाय च नमः आतार्याय च लाड्याय च नमः आतार्याय च लाड्याय च नमः शष्प्याय च फेन्याय च नमः सिकत्याय च प्रवाह्याय च नम इरिण्याय च प्रपत्याय च नमः किगुंशिलाय च क्षयणाय च नमः कपर्दिने च पुलस्तये च नमो गोष्ठ्याय च गृह्याय च नमः स्तल्प्याय च गेह्याय च नमः काट्याय च गह्वरेष्ठाय च नमो हृदयाय च निवेश्याय च नमः पागुंसव्याय च रजस्याय च नमः शुष्क्याय च हरित्याय च नमो लोप्याय चोलप्याय च नमः ऊर्म्याय च सूर्म्याय च नमः पर्ण्याय च पर्ण्यसध्याय च नमो बगुरमानाय च भिघ्नते च नमः आखिडते च प्रखिडते च नमो वक्षिरिकेभ्यो देवानागुं हृदयेभ्यो नमो विक्षीणकेभ्यो नमो विचिन्वत्केभ्यो नम आनिर्हतेभ्यो नम आमीवत्केभ्यः ॐ राजाधिराजाय प्रसंयसाहिने नमो वयं वै श्रवणाय कुर्महे समे कामान् कामकामाय मह्यम् कामेश्वरो वै श्रवणो दधातु कुबेराय वै श्रवणाय महाराजाय नमः ॐ सोमो वाये तस्य राज्यमाधत्ते यो राजा सन्राज्यो वा सोमेन यजते देवसुवा मेधानि हवीगुंसि भवन्ति य एतावन्तो वै देवानागुंसवाः त एवास्मै सवान् प्रयच्छन्ति तेन पुनः सुवन्ते राज्याय देवसुराजा भवति ॐ हां हौं शिवाय नमः श्रीनित्यानन्देश्वरी पराशक्तिसमेत श्रीनित्यानन्देश्वर परमशिवाय नमः नीराजनं संदर्शयामि। ओम दशांगं गुग्गुलोपेतं सुगंधं च सुमनोहरं आग्रेय सर्वदेवानां धूपोयं प्रतिगृह्यता। ओम हां ओम शिवाय नमः। श्री नित्यानंदे श्री पराशक्ति समेत श्री नित्यानंदेश्वर परम शिवाय नमः। धूपमाग्रापयामि। ओम उद्दीप्य स्वजात वेदापग्निम् निर्दिम्म पशुगुह्यम ह्यम वह जीवनम चतिशो दशा मानोहिकं सीर्यात वेदो गाम स्वंपुरुषं जगत अभिभ्यतग्नागिः श्रियाम परिपातया। ओम हां हों शिवाय नमः। श्री नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्ति समेत श्री नित्यानंदेश्वर परम शिवाय नमः। दीपं दर्शयामि। अमृते अमृतोद्भवे अमृतवर्षिणी अमृतं श्रावय श्रावय स्वाहा। ओम हां हों शिवाय नमः। श्री नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्ति समेत श्री नित्यानंदेश्वर परम शिवाय नमः। नैवेद्यं निवेदयामि। नीराजनम् ओम ईशान सर्व विद्यानां ईश्वर सर्व भूतानां ब्रह्माधिपतिर् ब्रह्मणोधिपतिर् ब्रह्मा शिवो मे अस्तु सदा शिवो। ओम हां हों शिवाय नमः। श्री नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्ति समेत श्री नित्यानंदेश्वर परम शिवाय नमः। नीराजनं संदर्शयामि रक्षां धारयामि। पुष्पांजलि ओम यापां पुष्पं वेदा पुष्पवान ब्रजावान वसुमान भवति चंद्रमा वा अपां पुष्पां पुष्पवान ब्रजावान वसुमान भवति य एवं वेदा योपाम आयतनं वेदा आयतनवान भवति। The first offering at the divine lotus feet of Sri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Samet Sri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva is the offering of the Chaturvedam, the offering of the favorite lines and the hymns from the four Vedas. At the divine lotus feet of Paramashiva, Devadevottama Devata Sarvabhoma Akhilanda Kodi Brahmanda Nayaka Sri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sameta Sri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva चतुर्वेद प्रिय चतुर्वेदम अवधारय। हरि ओम अग्निमीले पुरोहितं यज्ञस्य देवमृत्विजं होता आरं रत्नधातामं हरि ओम हरि ओम इशेर्त्वो जेत्वा वायवस्तो वायवस्तदेवो वस्सविता प्राप्रजयुस्येष्टतमाय कर्मणे हरि ओम हरि ओम अग्न आयाहि वीतये ग्रहाणो हव्यधातये निहोता सत्सि बर्हिषि हरि ओम हरि ओम शन्नो देवी रभिष्टय आपो भवन्तु बीतये शन्यो रभिष्ट्रवन्तु नः हरि ओम
The next offering at the Divine Lotus Feet of Sri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sameta Sri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva. The next offering at the Divine Lotus Feet of Sri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sameta Sri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva is the offering of the Agama Shloka, the offering of select hymns from the Agamas.
Devadevottama Devata Sarvabhoma Khilandakoti Brahmanda Nayaka Sri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sameta Sri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva Agama Shloka Priya Agama Shloka Navadharaya श्री भगवानुवाच अतिकौतूहलाविष्ठा पृच्छश्रेतच्छृणु प्रिये यन्मे नेत्रांतरे वह्निर्यद्वामृतमनुत्तमम्
The next offering at the Divine Lotus Feet of Sri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sameta Sri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva is the offering of the Samaganam, the offering of the favorite hymns from the Samaveda of Paramashiva. The offering of the favorite hymns from the Samaveda to Paramashiva.
देवदेवोत्तमदेवताः सार्वभौमः अखिलाण्डकोटिब्रह्माण्डनायकः श्रीनित्यानन्देश्वरी पराशक्तिसमेतः श्रीनित्यानन्देश्वरपरमशिवः सामगानप्रियः सामगानम् अवधारय एतत्सामगायन्नास्ते हावोहावोहावो अहमन्नम 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 अहमन्नादो अहमन्नादो अहमन्नादः अहग्श्लोककृत अहमस्मि प्रथमचारुतास्य पूर्वं देवेभ्यो अमृतस्य न भाई यो मा ददाति शैले वमावाह अहमन्नमन्नमधन्तमाद्मि अहं विश्वं भुवमवभ्य भवान् सुवर्णज्योतिः हरिः ओम्
The next offering at the Divine Lotus Feet of Sri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sameta Sri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva is the offering of the Stotras.
देवदेवोत्तम देवता सार्वभौम अखिलांड कोटि ब्रह्मांड नायक श्री नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्ति समेत श्री नित्यानंदेश्वर परम शिव स्त्रोत्र प्रिय स्तोत्रम अवधारय दुःस्वप्न दुःशकुन दुर्गति धौर्मनस्य दुर्भिक्ष दुर्व्यसन दुःसह दुर्यसांसि उत्पाततात विषभीतिमसद्ग्रहाति व्याधीश्च नात्युजुमे जगतामधीशः ओम नमो भगवते सदाशिवाय सकलतत्वात्मकाय सर्वमंत्रस्वरूपाय सर्वयंत्राधिष्ठिताय सर्वतंत्रस्वरूपाय सर्वतत्वविधूराय ब्रह्मरुद्रावतारिणे नीलकंठाय पार्वतीमनोहराय सोमसूर्याग्निलोचनाय भस्मोद्धूलितविग्रहाय महामणिमुकुटधारणाय माणिक्यभूषणाय सृष्टिस्थितिप्रलयकालरौद्रावताराय दक्षाद्वरध्वंसकाय महाकालभेदनाय मूलाधारैकनिलयाय तत्वातीताय गंगाधराय सर्वदेवादिदेवाय सदाश्रयाय वेदांतसाराय त्रिवर्गसाधनाय अनंतकोटिब्रह्मांडनायकाय वासुकितक्षककार्कोटकशङ्खकुलिकपद्ममहापद्मेति अष्टमहानागकुलभूषणाय प्रणवस्वरूपाय चिदाकाशाय आकाशदिक्स्वरूपाय ग्रहनक्षत्रमालिने सकलाय कलंकरहिताय सकललोकैककर्त्रे सकललोकैकभर्त्रे सकललोकैकसंहत्रे सकललोकैकगुरवे सकललोकैकसाक्षिने सकलनिगमगुह्याय सकलवेदान्तपारगाय सकललोकैकवरप्रदाय सकललोकैकशङ्कराय शाङ्कशेखराय शाश्वतनिजाभासाय निराभासाय निरामयाय निर्मलाय निर्लोभाय निर्मदाय निश्चिन्ताय निरवन्द्वाय निरंकुशाय निष्कलंकाय निर्गुणाय निष्कामाय निरुपद्रवाय निरवद्याय निरंतराय निष्कारणाय निरन्तकाय निष्प्रपञ्चाय निस्संघाय निर्द्वन्द्वाय निराधाराय निष्क्रोधाय निर्मलाय निष्पापाय निर्मयाय निरञ्जनाय निरुपमविभयाय नित्यशुद्धबुद्धपरिपूर्णसच्चिदानन्दाद्वयाय परमशान्तस्वरूपाय तेजोरूपाय तेजोमयाय जय जय रुद्र महारुद्र भद्रावतार महाभैरव कालभैरव कल्पान्तभैरव कपालमालाधर खड्मांग खड्ग चर्म पाशांकुश धर्म शूल चाप भान गदा शक्ति भिंदि बाल तोमर मुसल मुद्गर पाशभरिग भुषुंधीशदग्नी चक्रात्यायुध भीषण कर सहस्रमुख दंष्ट्राकरालवधन विकटाट्टहास विस्फारित ब्रह्मांड मंडल नागेन्द्र कुंडल नागेन्द्रहार नागेन्द्र वलय नागेन्द्र चर्मधर मृत्युंजय त्र्यंबक त्रिपुरांतक विश्वरूप विरूपाक्ष विश्वेश्वर वृषभवाहन विषभूषण विश्वतो मुख सर्वतो रक्ष रक्ष मां ज्वल ज्वल महामृत्युम् अपमृत्युभयं नाशय नाशय चोरभयं उत्साहय उत्साटय विषसर्पभयं शमय शमय चोरान् मारय मारय मम शत्रूनुच्छादय उच्छाटय त्रिशूलेन विधारय विधारय कुठारेण भिन्दि भिन्दि खड्गेन छिन्दि छिन्दि खड्गांगेन विपोथव विबोधय विचलेन निष्पेषय निष्पेषय भानैः संताडय संताडय रक्षांसि भीषय भीषय भूतानि विद्रावय विद्रावय कूष्माण्डमारीच वेताल ब्रह्मराक्षसगणान् संत्रासय संत्रासय माम् अभयं कुरु कुरु वित्रस्थं माम् आश्वासय आश्वासय नरकभयां माम् उद्धर उद्धर संजीवय संजीवय क्षुत्रुभ्यां माम् आप्यायय आप्यायय दुःखातुरां माम् आनन्दय आनन्दय शिवकवचेन माम् आच्छादय आच्छादय मृत्युं जय त्र्यम्बक सदाशिव नमस्ते नमस्ते।
The next offering at the Divine Lotus Feet of Sri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Samet Sri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva is the offering of the Dravida Vedam, the offering of the sacred hymns, devotional hymns written by the various saints of various saints from the Dravida Desha who have achieved oneness with Paramashiva. And from that space, Indra Dravida Bhasha, in one of the favorite languages of Paramashiva, have written devotional hymns unto him from that same space of oneness.
Deva Deva Uttama Devata Sarva Bhuma अखिलांड कोटि ब्रह्मांड नायक श्री नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्ति समेत श्री नित्यानंदेश्वर परम शिव द्राविड वेद प्रिय द्राविड वेदम अवधारय तोडुडय सवियन तोडुडय सवियन विडय ओर्तुवन मडिसूरी काडुडय सुडले पोडी पोसियनुल्लम कवर कल्वन येडुडय मलरानुने नान पिनंदें तरुल सेदा पीडुडय पिरमा पुरमे मिया पुन्वा निवनंद्रेन पीडुडय पिरमा पुरमे विया पम्मान इवनंद्रेन शिवा शिव तिरुचित्रम्बलम।
Now we'll offer at the Divine Lotus Feet of Sri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Samet Sri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva the offering of the Sangeeta Seva.
Devadevottama Devatas Sarvabhuma Akhilanda Koti Brahmanda Nayaka श्री नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्ति समेत श्री नित्यानंदेश्वर परम शिव संगीत प्रिय संगीतम अवधारय बोलो नाता उमापते शंभो शंकर पशुपते, बोलो नाता उमापते शंभो शंकर पशुपते, नंदीवाहन नागभूषण चंद्रशेखर जटाधरा, गंगाधर गौरी मनोहर गंगाधर गौरी मनोहर, गिरिजाकांता सदा शिवा गिरिजाकांता सदा शिवा, बोलो नादा उमापते शंभो शंकर पशुपते, बोलो नादा उमापते शंभो शंकर पशुपते, मूलाधारा ज्योति प्रकाश मूलाधारा ज्योति प्रकाश, विभूति सुंदर परमेश विभूति सुंदर परमेश, स्मशानवास चिदंबरेश स्मशानवास चिदंबरेश, नीलकंठ महादेवा जय नीलकंठ महादेवा, बोलो नादा उमापते शंभो शंकर पशुपते, कैलासवास कनक प्रवेश कैलासवास कनक सभेश, चिदंबरेश विश्वेश चिदंबरेश विश्वेश, भं भं शंकर डमरुकनाद भं भं शंकर डमरुकनाद, पार्वती रमना सदा शिवा पार्वती रमना सदा शिवा पार्वती रमना सदा शिवा पार्वती रमना सदा शिवा, हर हर महादेव की जय। The next offering at the Divine Lotus Feet of Shri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sameta Shri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva. Is the offering of the Tirukailaya Vadyam, the favorite drums and the drum beat of Paramashiva. देवदेवोत्तम देवता सार्वभौम अखिलांड कोटि ब्रह्मांड नायक श्री नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्ति समेत श्री नित्यानंदेश्वर परम शिव, कैलाय वाद्य प्रिय कैलाय वाद्यम अवधारय।
देवदेवोत्तमं देवता सार्वभौमं अखिलांडकोटिब्रह्मांडनायकं. The next offering at the divine lotus feet of Sri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Samet Sri Nityanandeshwar Paramashiva is the Paramashiva Shakti Avishkarana. The offering of the fruit of our devotion to Paramashiva is the manifestation of Paramashiva Shaktis. We offer them at His divine lotus feet.
Deva Devottama Devata Sarvabhuma Akhilanda Godi Brahmandanayaka Shri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sameta Shri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva Paramashiva Shakti Avishkarana Priya Paramashiva Shakti Avishkaranam Avadharaya.
Nityanandam, as part of today's offering towards Sri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sameta Sri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva is today's Anuttamottama Seva. We are here to offer this Paramashiva Shakti Avishkarana, this manifestation of consciousness or matter, to our beloved Guru Bhagavan Sri Nityananda Paramashiva. Before entering into the science of our manifestation, a few words of how Swamiji, His Divine Holiness, brought this into existence and how it has become a science for each and every single individual of us. Swamiji is an avatar from a cosmic millennium where He manifests the space, state, powers, being, super consciousness and Kailasa of Paramashiva in His being, wherein in Agamas, which are the source book of Hinduism, about 463 plus powers are clearly mentioned. One such power is this consciousness or matter. So with the space of oneness, having a cognition, Swamiji, you and me are the one and the same, and surrendering to Him, allowing Him to flow through you with the space of oneness and chanting the Maha Maha Vakya, Om Nityananda Paramashivam, the sacred vibration chants, and allow to make the manifestation takes place. So now let us all get into the space of oneness and manifest this power of Paramashiva.
Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. 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 Nityananda Paramashivoham. Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham.
With this we offer the science of manifestation of powers towards Sri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Samhita Sri Nityanandeshwari Paramashiva as part of today's Uttamottama Seva. Thank you, Nityanandam.
Deva Devottamam Devata Sarvabhaumam Akhilanda Godi Brahmandanayakam Shri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sameta Shri Nityanandeshwara Paramashivam Ashtapushpair Abhyaccha. Om Sarvasyapte Sarvasya Jivve Sarvadena Meva Apnoti Sarvam Jayate. Om Ham Hom Shivaya Namaha Shri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Samet Shri Nityanandeshwara Paramashivaya Namaha Ekardi Deepam Sandarshayami.
The next offering at the Divine Lotus Feet of Sri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Samyak Sri Nityanandeshwara Varamashiva is the offering of the Swasti Mantra, the favorite offering of blessings from Paramashiva.
Devadevottama Devata Sarvabhuma Akhilanda Koti Brahmanda Nayaka Sri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Samyata Sri Nityanandeshwara Varamashiva Ashirvada Priya Ashirvadham Avadharaya. ॐ स्वस्ति प्रजाभ्य परिवालयन्तां ज्ञायेन मार्गेण महिं महिषाः गोब्राह्मणेभ्यः शुभमस्तु नित्यं लोका समस्ता सुखिनो भवन्तु काले वर्षतु वर्जन्यः पृथिवी सच्चालिनी देशोऽयं क्षोभरहितः ब्राह्मणा सन्तु निर्भयाः इति स्वस्ति मन्त्रार्था सत्या सफला भवन्तु इति भवन्तो महान्तो न गृह्णन्तु तथास्तु अवुत्रा पुत्रिणस्सन्तु पौत्रिणः अधना सधना सन्तु जीवन्तु सरदर्शतम् इति भवन्तो महान्तो न गृह्णन्तु तथास्तु दुर्जनस्सज्जनो भूयात् सज्जनश्शान्तिमाप्नुयात् शान्तो मुच्येत वन्देभ्यः मुक्तश्चान्यान् विमोचयेत् इति भवन्तो महान्तो न गृह्णन्तु तथास्तु राजा धर्मपतिः प्रजा सुच्चरिताः पूजा धना सज्जनाः षट्कर्म प्रवरा द्विजाः प्रतिदिनं विद्यानवद्या सदा वाणी सन्निहिता चिरं कविमुखैः सानन्दमव्याकुलाः सर्वे सन्तु वैदिकधर्म अनुष्ठातारः सौजन्यसन्तोषिणः इति स्वस्ति मन्त्रार्था सत्या सफला भवन्तो इति भवन्तो महान्तो न गृह्णन्तो तथास्तु येषां देवदेवानां महादेवानां अखिलाण्डकोटिब्रह्माण्डनायकानां सकलभुविशुस्तिस्थितिसंहारतिरोभाव अनुग्रहाख्य पञ्चकृत्यपरायणानाम् आदिमध्यान्तरहितानाम् अप्रमेयपराक्रमाणां दत्त्वार्थगोचनानां श्रीनित्यानन्देश्वरी पराशक्तिसमेत श्रीनित्यानन्देश्वर परमशिवस्वरूपानां श्री आदिगुरु अरुणगिरियोगीश्वरस्वरूपानां श्रीकालभैरव महाकालीस्वरूपानां श्रीकैलासोन्नतद्वादशान्तश्यामलापीठारूढ श्रीमीनाक्षी सुन्दरेश्वराभिन्नस्वरूप परशिवपुत्र रत्नकुमार गुरुमन्यतुल्यावतार श्रीपार्वती स्तन्यपानलब्धदिव्यज्ञानविश्रुत सकल निगमागमसारभूत द्राविड वेद प्रवक्त्रे श्रीमत् परमशिव करुणा समितिगत मुक्तामय चतुरश्रयान गीयमान छत्रचामर श्रीचिह्नकाहलादि समस्त विरडावल्यलंकृत ज्ञान विज्ञान चक्रवर्ती सर्वजनसंघ सत्यो निर्माण दीक्षा व्ययापवर्ग वर्ष विष्णान जीमूत परमत कलभ केसरी शैव सिद्धांत स्थापनाचार्य श्री राजाधिराज पांड्य महाराजगुरु क्षमनशाख्यादि महांधकार निवारण ज्ञान भानु वीक्षणानर्हार द्वदोच्छेदन पूर्वक श्रीमद्वृषभध्वज स्थापक शैव समय गर्द्र सर्वज्ञ पीठारूढ श्री जगद्गुरु श्री ज्ञान संबंध देशिक स्वामी बागीश सुंदर माणिक्य वाचक स्वामीनाम अवतार भूत श्री ज्ञान संबंध स्वामी पुनरुद्धृत श्यामला पीठ सर्वज्ञ पीठ त्रिणवत्युत्तर द्विशत तम गुरु महासन्निधान अरुणगिरि योगीश्वर परंपरागत अरुणाचल सर्वज्ञ पीठ गुरु महासन्निधान कैलास परंपरागत कांची कैलास सर्वज्ञ पीठ त्रयस्त्रिंशदुत्तर द्विशत तम गुरु महासन्निधान नित्योत्सव नित्य मंगल नित्य कल्याण नित्य रजितादि कैलास नित्यानंद पीठ महासंस्थान महासिंहासन पीठ कर्त्रे साक्षात् श्री परम शिव समद्भूत कैलास परंपरागत वैवस्वत मनु इक्ष्वाकुहरिश्चंद्र भगीरथ श्रीरामचंद्र शूरसेन इत्याद्यनवच्छिन्न सार्वभौम चक्रवर्ती परंपरागत चतुष्षष्टि योगिनी मंडिता चतुष्षष्टि संप्रदाय प्रवर्तक मनुधर्म शासन सूर्यवंश प्राप्त सर्वज्ञ पीठ सुरांगी साम्राज्य मूर्धाभिषिक्त चूड़ामणि साक्षात् श्री परम शिव समुद्भूत कपिल महागुरु पुनरुद्धृत महानिर्वाण पीठ अष्टोत्तर सहस्र श्री महामंडलेश्वर साक्षात् श्री परम शिव समुद्भूत कैलास परंपरागत श्री महागणपति समारंभ अनवच्छिन्न पीठाधीश्वर गुरु परंपरा प्राप्त अटल पीठ अष्टोत्तर सहस्र तम अष्टोत्तर सहस्र श्री अटलपीठाधीश्वर धर्म मुक्ति स्वर्गपुर स्वर्णपीठ त्रयोविंश गुरु महासन्निधान श्री कैलास पुनरुद्धारक श्री कैलास परमाचार्य आदि
कैलास परंपरागत आदिपीठ सर्वज्ञपीठ जगद्गुरु श्रीमत्परमहंस सपरिव्राजकाचार्य वर्यानां सच्चिदानंद प्रणव स्वरूपानां श्रोत्रिय ब्रह्मनिष्ठानां श्रीमज्जगद्गुरूनां श्रीलश्री भगवत श्री नित्यानंद परम शिव श्री ज्ञान संबंध देशिक परमाचार्य स्वामिनां पादारविंदयोः भक्ति सिद्धिः समेषां सहकुटुंबानां सकलेश्वर्य प्राप्तिः गुरुगुरुबाकटाक्ष सिद्धिः क्षेम स्थैर्य वीर्य विजय आयुरारोग्य ऐश्वर्यानाम अभिवृद्धि आरोग्य दृढ़गात्रता सिद्धि आचंद्रार्क वंशाभिवृद्धि धर्मार्थ काम मोक्ष चतुर्विध फल पुरुषार्थ सिद्धि सर्वेषां मनसा चिंतित सत्कार्यानुकूल सिद्धि सर्वदेव देवी स्वरूपस्य भगवच्छ्री नित्यानंद परमशिवस्य पादारविंदयोः अचंचला भक्ति सिद्धि भगवच्छ्री नित्यानंद परमशिव प्रसादेन सकुटुंबस्य जैन वैराग्य जीवन मुक्ति प्राप्तिश्च भूयात् इति भवन्तो महान्तो न गृह्णन्तो तथास्तु सर्वे जना सुखिनः सन्तु तथास्तु सर्वेषां शान्तिर्भवतु तथास्तु समस्त सन्मंगलानि सन्तु तथास्तु सर्वत्र नित्यानंद ध्वजारोहणं भवतु तथास्तु सर्वेषां भगवान् श्रील श्री नित्यानंद परम शिव श्री ज्ञान संबंध देशिक परमाचार्य स्वामिनां परिपूर्ण कृपा कटाक्ष सिद्धि अस्तु तथास्तु अयम धर्मः उत्तरोत्तरम अभिवृद्धिरस्तु तथास्तु सर्वं भगवच्छ्री नित्यानंद परम शिव पादुकार्पणमस्तु ओम नित्यानंदम मंगलम कल्पवृक्षाय मंगलम ज्ञानधायिने सदाशिवाय श्री नित्यानंदेश्वराय मंगलम मंगलम श्री विद्यांबाये मंगलम कामदायिन्ये सर्वमंगलधात्रे नित्यानंदेश्वर्ये मंगलम मंगलम गुरुदेवाय मोक्षमूलाय मंगलम परावतार नित्यानंदाय गुरवे मंगलम ध्यान मूलं गुरोर्मूर्ति पूजा मूलं गुरोपदं मंत्र मूलं गुरोर्वाक्यं मोक्ष मूलं गुरोकृपा मूलमंत्रं यथाशक्ति जप्त्वा ओम यत्किंचित् कर्म देवेश सदा सुकृतस्कृतं तन्मे शिववदस्थस्य भुङ्क्ष क्षभय शंकर शिवो धाता शिवो भोक्ता शिवः सर्वमिदं जगत् शिवो यति सर्वत्र यः शिवः सोऽहमेवतु ओम पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ओम शांति 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 हरिः ओम तत्सत् सर्वं भगवच्छ्री नित्यानंद वरम शिव पादुकार्पणमस्तु ओम नित्यानंदम द नेक्स्ट ऑफरिंग एट द डिवाइन लोटस फीट ऑफ श्री नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्ति समेत श्री नित्यानंदेश्वर वरम शिव इज द ज्ञान पाद विवरण देवदेवोत्तम देवता सार्वभौम अखिलांड कोटि ब्रह्मांड नायक श्री नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्ति समेत श्री नित्यानंदेश्वर परम शिव ज्ञानपाद विवरण प्रिय ज्ञानपाद विवरणम अवधारय
शिवोहम् ओम नित्यानंद परम शिवोहम् ओम नित्यानंद परम शिवोहम् ओम नित्यानंद परम शिवोहम्
नित्यानंदं परमसुखदं केवलं ज्ञानमूर्तिं द्वंद्वातीतं गगनसदृशं तत्त्वमस्यादिलक्ष्यं एकं नित्यं विमलमचलं सर्वदी साक्षिभूतं भावातीतं त्रिगुणरहितं सद्गुरुं तं नमामि. नित्यानंदं, welcome to Nitya Satsang with Supreme Pontiff of Hinduism, His Divine Holiness, Bhagavan Sri Nityananda Paramashivam. Before the satsang begins, we wanted to discuss some of the major events happening in Shri Kailasa, the only Hindu nation. A revival by His Divine Holiness, Bhagavan Sri Nityananda Paramashivam, to revive Hinduism back to its glory, back to its best days. Today
we'll be discussing a topic of the caste system, the biggest conspiracy against Hinduism. The caste system was a way to divide and rule a country that had the richest and the most diverse and skilled population on the planet. The amount of wealth and the amount of diversity and variety of skills that the Hindus were able to give out from this country was a tremendous amount. But to divide it and to create problems between the various aspects, the various types of people in the society, the caste system was a creation of anti-Hindu elements against the very nature of Hindu, Sanatana Hindu Dharma. Today, you can make a vote on caste system at tinyurl.com/hinduvotes. The caste system is the biggest conspiracy against Hinduism. Caste by verse versus arithmetics. One of us, each one of us has two biological parents, a father and a mother, and similarly we have four grandparents and eight great-grandparents and so on. But put otherwise, as we go backwards for each generation, the number of ancestors doubles for the previous generations. It is basically a simple mathematical phenomena. In a mathematical notation, it is written as 2 raised to the n, where n is equal to the number of generations ago. If one calculates the value for, say, 10 generations, we get a value of 1,024 ancestors. That is great, 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 great grandparents. Continuing on to 20 generations ago, we get an astonishing astronomical figure of 10,48,576 only. Caste by birth versus caste by arithmetics. This is a mathematical reality, not just a gimmick. The current population of the Republic of India alone is at 130 crores, 1.3 billion people. This excludes the population of the United India, that is the pre-1935 Government of Act India Territory Nations of Burma, but now Myanmar, Ceylon, Sri Lanka, Pakistan and Bangladesh. If everyone's ancestral count 20 generations ago was added, the total would exceed the number of humans ever lived on this planet. This shows that the largest population that ever existed and has ever been existing and has a complete dominance in the population, if you take the land masses of the entire Akhanda Bharata and put them together, you find that it is a tremendous amount of population. Mathematicians have shown that just 20 generations ago, our ancestors were all brothers, sisters and cousins. All of us alive now share the same ancestors. This is technically called the pedigree collapse. The implications of the pedigree collapse are that there could have been no caste by birth in existence then, as they were all from the same extended family. How can there be different castes by birth within a family? Of course, each one can become a doctor, a soldier, a priest, and so on by merit though. Thus, our eminent historians and politicians have been perpetrating a lie used by the British Christians to further the agenda of the divide and rule. If castes were by birth and set in stone, how did they grow exponentially in number within a few decades? Do they reproduce? Even if they do reproduce, how can they grow beyond and exponentially over the population's rate of growth? Manufacturing imaginary ghost casts. Imaginary ghost casts. Going back to the above table, the total Indian Hindu population was counted at 207 million approximately in the 1901 census. Remember that this includes the present day Pakistan, Bangladesh and Burma. Interestingly, the 85 chief castes of India are said to have made up a population size of approximately 214 million. And add the odd discrepancy of about 7 million can be attributed by castes by birth being present among Sikhs and Indian converts to Christianity. However, the 1901 census admittedly counted castes only among the Hindus and Jains, the report says. So we have, by an arithmetical law of averages, only two possible scenarios. Some people are being counted into more than one caste. That is, people belong to more than one caste at the same time. So much for caste by birth being set in stone. And some castes must have no people or negative numbers of people in it. Negative numbers of people in a population census. So the numbers, we can see here that the numbers have been completely messed up to say that the whole of India is suffering from a caste system problem. Because firstly, arithmetically, logically, to be able to create such a population, you can't have a segregated caste system where people are bound to only marry inside their own caste or live amongst their own caste. It had to have been a freedom to be able to marry anybody and have the freedom to work with and live with any profession to be able to expand at the rate at which India had expanded as far as population. And given that there remains hardly any population left to distribute among the chief 85 castes, there will be hundreds of castes. That is, about 95% or thereabouts are bogus non-existent nomical castes with only a few hundred numbers. If at all, there were indeed castes recorded with which could have had no members. Means they were all made up. Yet somehow recorded in the census, this is the only conclusion from a purely arithmetic point of view. Simple law of averages to repeat. Gotra versus caste. Dr. Ambedkar quotes two Gotra enumerations, one in Punjab and the other in Maharashtra. He found that the same set of Gotras were present in the lowest of the castes and the highest of the Brahmin castes in both of these states, covering among the entire western and northwestern India. Dr. Ambedkar concluded that all castes were once at least apparently related and caste by birth must have been a relatively recent phenomena. Genetics.
we have a leader of India, the man who wrote in the constitution, saying himself that and proving him that caste is a recent phenomena. It is something made up. It's a problem given to us. It is a way to say that there is a problem. There is something wrong with it. Something wrong with the way you live. There's something wrong. It is the cause of all these things. It's very easy to say and point a finger at this thing and say, this is the reason. And it has been done to us, and it has created something that is so convoluted, something that is so unnecessary, but it's there and it's being used against us. That is the caste system, and saying that there is a caste system. But it's clearly, we can see here that it's all an imaginary ghost caste system. It doesn't really exist. It's just the way the country is. And something they say that we are told is something wrong with it. But if you think there's something wrong with it and we have something to blame, that is enough for somebody to continuously beat at that on you and make you feel that there's you were wronged. And this is the way that the anti-Hindu forces clearly make the population, Hindu population, feel completely useless, feel completely beaten down throughout history and have a meaningless history. The strength of Hinduism comes from the knowledge of our past, from the knowledge of our ancestors, and the remembering that our ancestors always did the right thing, lived a dharmic life, lived a righteous life. Rather, with these ideas of caste system and these ideas that people were subdivided and people were not allowed and there were such things as untouchability and all these kind of things. With these ideas, the whole history of India is, the whole history of Hinduism is told as if we have nothing proud to look back at. And if someone feels completely have nothing proud to look back at, that person doesn't have a sense of deep culture and a deep meaning and a deep sense of origin as far as their culture and religion is concerned. To give back this power, to empower the strength of the stories of the itihas of Hinduism, where dharma was followed, where all these rishis, the gotras, where all these rishis were from whom the Hindu population came from, are all dharmic people who had who manifested tremendous powers of Paramashiva, who by Paramashiva's grace propagated Hinduism all over India, all over the world also, and lived extreme enlightened lives and lived in a very dharmic way. To be able to live by those same principles that Paramashiva has laid out, let us vote. If we are still having the pride of being the oldest living civilization, it is because of the Varnashrama Dharma. Is this beautiful structure was destroyed by Mughals during the Mughal invasion and twisted and distorted by the British, saying that only by birth Varna exists and Jati and Varna are the same. It is the worst crime done by Britishers. Varna are 4 in number and Jati are 30,000 in number. That itself should make you understand Varna is different and Jati is different. And the beauty is, if you do not want to fit into any of these Varnas or Jatis, you are free to declare yourself as Paramahamsa, and then you can be out of the great lifestyle, and you are respected by people who will support you, feed and worship you. You do not need to become a thief. But the beauty, that is the beauty of the Hindu society. So the vote is, should caste system based on Jati Varna be brought back? And this is something that you can participate in on tinyurl.com/hinduvotes. Genetics versus historians. From one of the northernmost state of Uttarakhand to the southernmost state of Tamil Nadu, data shows that the now so-called Dalits or scheduled castes are genetically closest to, in other words, belong to the same larger group as the Brahmins and Kshatriya castes. than the other castes. Of course, this is on the background of a completely admixed pan-Indian populace. Propagandas called scientists, the same geneticists that have now been lured by the Harvard bribery, that is, visiting faculty positions and have started to ignore or hide their own evidence. Recently, they removed data points showing Andamese DNA being present to the tune of 1/3 or thereabouts of an ancient DNA sample over 5,000 years before in Western Siberia. This was done to propagate Aryan invasion / migration hypothesis, which is used to claim castes by birth somehow existed using some kind of arithmetical quantum gymnastics. We can see that those who we feel are going to help us for the future, give us more insight into the future, give us more insight into the way the world works, who are called scientists, themselves are falling into not answering or not revealing the truths that they find and giving misinformation because of a mistake or an agenda that had been placed hundreds of years ago. You can see that scientists even today would adhere that, oh, then if this comes out to be true, it'll make a tragic difference in the world. Rather than coming out with the truth and coming out with the truth that they discover based off the DNA samples they do on the they take from the Andamanese, that they have a link to the Western Siberian people. This revelation is a scientific revelation that is sugar-coated and completely hidden, because they need to stick with the already told grand narrative, a narrative that has been going on really to destroy the whole psyche of the Hindu populace, to give the Hinduism, make it illegitimate in the world, a grand narrative to destroy the Hinduism, that is the Aryan invasion and a migration, that Hindus migrated into India, they were not from India. This whole hypothesis was a grand narrative made up to show that what was originally from the country is not from Hinduism at all. We can vote to say that no, everything originated from Hinduism at tinyurl.com/hindu-votes. Bhagavan Sri Nityananda Paramashivam, His Divine Holiness, is showing us how we have been lied to, how we have been manipulated, and how through our education and throughout our lives, all these science, all the real facts have been hidden from us. Now let us see a video.
Welcome back. Time for all of us to think. Dhruva, or Maharishi, a great Maharishi, was one of the greatest devotees of Shiva, of Vishnu, was born to a demon. Vyasa, who scribed the Vedas, the Bhagyantam, the Brahma Sutras, and almost every major scripture, was born to a fisher woman. Vishwamitra, who gave the Gayatri Mantra, which is what now, today, every Brahmin recites daily, was born as a Kshatriya king. Black-skinned Rama and Krishna, the greatest incarnations of Lord Vishnu, who are worshipped in every Hindu temple and worshipped by every Hindu, were born as Kshatriyas, not as Brahmanas. If this idea of hierarchy of Varnas or Jatis was true, why would Brahmins who preserve these texts retain these Puranas, why would they retain rules that forces them to beg for a living? Brahmin, if it is a hierarchy, the benefits, the highest benefits are for those on the top. It doesn't, the way that the Varna system is set up, the Brahmin is said to be the most pious and humble of them all. That is how it's traditionally to be. But if it was a hierarchy and told that the Varna system is a means to make everyone at the bottom feel, deprive everybody at the bottom, make them feel that they are not even, they are a low life and they have no worth of living or worth of anything in society, then why would the Brahmana caste, the highest caste, resort to begging and eating? The rules are that they should beg for their food, and the society should support the Brahmanas because they are there to maintain the knowledge and the Vedas, to give the true truths of the knowledge of the Vedas to everybody who are around them. To preserve their knowledge, the Brahmanas are made. How is it that the Brahmanas in the highest part of society will become the highest part of society when they hold the spiritual core of the society and their lifestyle itself doesn't involve any wealth at all, whereas they only beg for their living? Experience breakthrough healing, physical, mental, and emotional through the powerful cognitions given by Sri Kailasa. Be an e-citizen of Kailasa and register for a free passport at join.kailasa.org and become part of this great movement to revive the only Hindu nation led by His Divine Holiness Bhagavan Sri Nityananda Paramashiva. Let us now see a video on Jati and Varna from His Divine Holiness.
Most abused concept Hinduism, all the anti-Hindu forces used these 4 or 5 concepts to attack Hinduism left and right, abuse Hinduism left and right. One is Varnashrama Dharma. We need to look into this whole community system with the idea of investigation, not with the idea of abusing. Be very clear. We are a civilization created for enlightenment. When somebody is not complete in this janma, he will take the birth in the next janma in the same family and ambience and will start where he has left and continue his journey. So our civilization is created for that. These invaders, if you don't believe in next janma, who are you to talk about our civilization? Anti-Hindu forces are the most dangerous forces for planet Earth, because neither they have knowledge nor they are interested in investigating. All they know is the brutal weapons, turning their weapons to the people who are investigating, contemplating this discrimination of community system itself was imposed on us by invaders. Please understand, the Gayatri mantra, which is chanted by all the Brahmins, is revealed by a Kshatriya, Vishwamitra. The Vyasa, who is worshipped by all the Brahmins, is the son of a boat fisherwoman, Shudra. If we want the Brahminical superiority to be established, don't we have that much of intelligence just to change the history? Instead of fisherwoman, we could have said one great Brahmin lady, Brahmin virgin lady, was sitting in the boat along with the fisherwoman. Vyasa was born for that lady. How much time it would have taken for us to change the history 2 lines? We were not interested in Brahminical supremacy. Understand, we were not interested in establishing any supremacy or authority. We were simply straight. Please understand, in every temple, all the Adishaivas have to worship. Adishaivas are the purest Brahmins and respected even by Brahmins as higher than the Brahmins. Please understand, the Adishaiva Brahmins are respected by the whole Brahmin community as higher than the Brahmins, because they take care, maintain the temple and do the seva to the gods, goddesses directly. So Adishaivas are respected higher than the Brahmins. Means they are, even in the Brahmin community, they are step higher. They have to worship every day the saints of Hindu tradition. In that saints, at least 20 of them are Dalits. Understand, I just wanted to tell the India's Dalit brothers and sisters. Hinduism never alienated you. You have been taught wrong history and you have been poisoned. The caste discrimination concept was forced on us. Please understand.
Welcome back. Varna by merit versus Varna versus caste by birth. Anti-Hindu elements often quoting our scriptures selectively, which we never open, is at the root cause of misinterpretations. Most of the anti-Hindus quote this sloka from Bhagavad Gita saying, here Krishna says, I have created the four castes depending upon the distribution of the three gunas or attributes. Anti-Hindu elements go on to say that caste problem stems from Krishna himself, which is a ridiculous conclusion. They always say the term that devil quotes the Bible means to be able to say that there is something wrong. Selective words can be taken, misplaced, misrepresented, and given a different meaning. To be able to give the meaning of a larger negative, destructive narrative. Handling the crisis in the Hindu way. Hindu system is contributing and liberating. Hindu administrative system is absolutely empowering and making you free. Hindu Vaishyatva, Hindu business, is extremely empowering and creative, expanding. And the whole Hindu wealth gets accumulated only to the persons who are contributing. Hindu economy says, wealth cannot be accumulated with blackmailing persons, because it is extremely life positive and is such a balancing system. The Brahminitva, the Brahmana Varna, is absolutely life positive about the knowledge. That is why they never make money out of knowledge. It is banned in Hindu economy because Parameshwara knows the moment you start making money out of knowledge, even the quality of knowledge can be compromised. Let us now see a video on Kailasha's take on caste system.
You need to understand. Let me read the whole question. Swamiji, you are born for Hinduism. What about casteism? First thing, you should be very clear. I am born from Hinduism, but I am born for the world, not for Hinduism. So you need to correct. I am born for the whole world. You are asking, what about casteism? This subject needs to be analyzed with more sympathy and compassion than Marxist terrorists, commie medias, and pseudo-secularists, militant missionaries and missionary militants. Don't look at the caste system from their view. I am dead against the discrimination based on caste system. Somebody is high, somebody is low. No, I am dead against. But I am not against the caste system itself. Understand? You are asking why in India there are a lot of castes. May I know you are from which country? India? Hyderabad, you are from India only. You live in India? You live in India only. Oh, that is why you don't know. Go to any country, you will see the caste system on the wrong scales. Listen. In US, night, you hear the calling bell sound. You go and peep through that hole. The small glass will be there on every door. What do you call that hole? See, keyhole. No, there will be lens. sealants. No, not the keyhole, ma. Peephole. You see, you peep through the peephole. If you see a man, white skin, fair complexion, and with a coat suit, shoes, trim, handsome, what, how you will react? Or a dark guy, fat, unshaved, standing, how will you react? Understand, there is no civilization where there is no caste system. When you see a black guy in the night, you automatically assume he is going to be attacking you. He is there for a wrong purpose. When you see a white guy in the night time, automatically assume, no, he is not for any wrong purpose. He may be asking for a shelter. Understand, by nature, human beings are animals which forms their own group. Why? Get into the flight, walk through the first class to go to economy. The fellows who are sitting in the first class, how they look at you? Is it not casteism? No Brahmana would have looked at any Kshatriya, any Shudra. In India, such a cheap way. The way the first class passengers look at the economy passengers. Especially in the international flights. So understand, in all countries, casteism is there. In many countries, now in the modern day, in the metropolitan cities like Hyderabad, Chennai, Bangalore, the apartments are there. A-level, three-bedroom apartment, two-bedroom apartment, single-bedroom apartment. In one complex, three different towers will be there. The single bedroom apartment residents, how they are treated by the three bedroom apartment residents? Do you know? How many of you are cognizing what I am saying? Then what? Understand, the Western civilization, casteism is based on money. In India, in Hinduism, casteism was created based on knowledge. But even then, I don't agree any reservation. I don't agree any reservation. I neither agree reservation for Dalits, nor agree reservation for Brahmins in Acharya Mahamandaleshwar post. Finally, I decided requesting them to change the constitution. They all decided, I agreed. I am dead against all reservations. Reservation is nothing but the outcome of vote bank politics. It is just vote bank politics. Why is there big caste and small caste? No, there's no big caste and small caste. So understand, it is individual. Individual. Individual who lives is responsible for caste. I tell you, caste comes by the action, not even by the birth. There are many so-called lower castes. Their statues, deities are worshipped every day by the great brahmanas in all temples of South India. Nandanar, Tirunilaganda Yazhpanar, all of them were so-called untouchables when they were in the body. Now their statues are touched by the Brahmins. So in Hinduism, caste was never based on birth. It was based on the life they live. It's based on the character. It is based on the character. If you are a person running in confusion without direction, you are a Shudra. If you are a person running towards wealth, you are Vaishya. If you are running towards power, you are Kshatriya. If you are running towards knowledge, you are Brahmana. That's all. Your goal decides your gotra. Not from the hole you came out. Your goal decides your gotra. Understand? Maine Hindu dharam mein janam avashya liya hai, kintu maine pure vishv ke लिया जन्म लिया है. मैं भारत की जात पात व्यवस्था से सहमत हूँ, किंतु जात पात के नाम पर भेदभाव का विरोध करता हूँ. हर देश में जात पात व्यवस्था है. उदाहरण, एक उद्यान में आप जाइए, देखिए, प्रथम श्रेणी के लोग इकॉनमी श्रेणी के लोगों को कैसे तुच्छ रूप से देखते हैं. क्या वो जात पात पर आधारित भेदभाव नहीं है? मैं रिजर्वेशन या आरक्षण का सख्त विरोध करता हूं. वो केवल वोट जमाने के लिए राजनीति है. केवल वोट जमाने के लिए राजनीति है. Understand, I neither agree with the commie Marxist terrorists, militant missionary militant views about casteism, nor agree with the discrimination based on the casteism. Caste is based on your mental setup, the responsibility you take it up, and there is no high or low. You need to understand. Let me read the whole question. Swamiji, you are born.
Your vote can contribute to the change. The Supreme Pontiff of Hinduism, Jagadguru Mahasannidhamanam, His Divine Holiness, Bhagavan Sri Nityananda Paramashivam, to Sri Kailasa, the world's greatest Hindu nation and the world's only Hindu nation, has been conducting responsible voting for the last 26 years, bringing about a huge revival of Hinduism. This time, the topic is extremely important for all of us as humans. For one vote can, your one vote can decide the quality of your life you live, especially in the caste system. Especially in this message of the caste system, where we can go back and go back to our roots and peacefully look back our past and history with pride and dignity. And rather than feeling that our past has been a negative past that has been based off greed
and not falling into the negative narratives that have been told to us. Your vote can change this. Go to tinyurl.com/hinduvotes and vote to bring back the original caste system, not a caste system, the Varnashrama Dharma, a dharma where everybody in society is contributing to each other's lives and helping each other remain and always be in oneness with Paramashiva. Let us now get ready for the Nitya Satsang. Please be seated with your head, neck, spine in a straight line and begin chanting the Mahavakya. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham.
Om Nityananda Paramashivoham.